Well, look at the very things I've identified, like letting a student keep now appeal the number of short suspensions they're getting. What's wrong with that?
Well, it's a decision for local schools, firstly. It shouldn't be made by a distant bureaucrat, which this would be. It would be made by a distant bureaucrat so far away from the actual school, so far away from the community that would be actually affected by those decisions. And essentially, it means that decisions like that will take longer, as they always do when you're dealing with the bureaucracy. And it means that people on the ground in schools don't actually have decision-making power. And that's the fundamental thing that is wrong with the education system, is that it is all centralised. And these issues won't be able to be addressed until we actually go local and start addressing issues from a local standpoint.
Yeah, well, the authority of the principal is undercut. The authority of the principal? Yeah, this undercuts the authority of the principal. What about removing gendered language? What's wrong with that?
Well, it seems a bit vague in terms of actual practicality, but it's vague by design because this radical gender ideology relies on confusion. And I think that's what the government are trying to push through here. They're removing it, they're removing gendered language from the Act, and that sets a precedent in schools for teachers to then have to follow up with that. And teachers are already pulling their hair out having to deal with this stuff in school. They're expected to be psychologists, they're expected to parent as well. They should just be allowed to teach.
And the inclusive and diversity agenda, that always makes me suspicious. What in practice does that mean?
Well, they actually quote the Anti-Racial Discrimination Act in Queensland in the same line that they say, oh, this isn't unlawful discrimination, but it is discrimination nonetheless. This relates to student support plans and teachers and schools having to treat them differently if they are Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander. And that's insulting to those people. And again, it sets a very dangerous precedent to the youngest people of Australia that, oh, actually, you do get treated differently on the basis of your race. It is utterly disgraceful.
Now Edward, I've only got 30 seconds left, a little bit longer. Your rival union, what are they saying about this?
Well, the QTU, the Queensland Teachers Union, the AU equivalent up here, they essentially helped draft the bill, but now because it's received such a backlash from teachers, they're dismissing themselves from it. So people don't often understand this, but the QTU are the philosophical arm of the Labor Party, and essentially they're doing each other's bidding in this. They're green-lighting the gender stuff and all of that sort of thing so that they can, you know, point to the other things that they're now opposing and say, hey, look, we actually are doing what we're doing for our members. But it's just not true.
It's a hand in the glove. Edward Schuller, thank you so much for your time.